Persecution against people for their religious beliefs has been taking place for centuries. But today, some Christians in Muslim countries say they are being singled out and persecuted for their religious ideas. One American organization, though, is trying to make a difference and help hundreds of people in Pakistani countries, helping out the Pakistani Christians. It's led by Keith Davies, founder and executive director of Rescue Christians. He is here joining us with more about the efforts that are underway. Thank you for being here. Let's talk for a moment about Rescue Christians. How did all this come to be?
Well, we actually run a think tank. We still do that work on the Middle East. A case came to us about 3 or 4 years ago that needed help. We started to call all the other organizations that we thought were actually rescuing people and helping people, and we found that not one of them would help, so we decided that we had to do it. So that's, we started 4 years ago with no knowledge, no experience, and 2 years later we've now saved over or helped over 1,000 people.
You know, we've heard reports about Christians being targeted in different countries around the globe. The images have been quite sobering and very unsettling, obviously, but the work that you're doing is taking place in Pakistan, correct?
That is correct. What we do, one of the hardest things for Christians to deal with is the blasphemy laws. And when they target Christians, they accuse them falsely of blasphemy. So what we do is we found safe houses for them, and in extreme situations we get them out of the country. We also, forced conversions and kidnapping of women is prevalent. I mean, it's unbelievable, the rape and the sodomization. It's just, we've dealt with two recent cases, were absolutely awful. So what we do is we rescue them. We've been very successful. In every case that we've taken on, we've been successfully able to rescue the girls. We also have been involved in cases of slavery, indenture. Many Christian families, if someone gets sick, they can't afford to pay for their treatment. So they sell themselves into basically slavery in the kiln works. And on several cases of those, we've actually been successful in doing.
Well, it's really amazing the work that you're doing. Obviously, you're up against tough challenges, but where are the authorities on all of this? I mean, when you are, you know, presented with these particular situations and you go to the authorities to try to seek some type of resolution, are they helpful at all?
Some are and some are not. It depends on who you're talking to. I mean, in fact, we just got a case in this morning where we're actually working on the legal side of things. And his name is Arif Yosef. He was arrested for blasphemy. And now he's been tortured and he's mentally retarded. The family went to visit him actually yesterday, and he didn't recognize them, and his hands were swollen, and he's obviously been tortured, and we're actually now dealing with that case, trying to get a medical certificate to see what the torture was. But so we're dealing
stories.
With the situation.
Yeah, these are horrific stories, and we applaud you for the work that you are doing, and we hope that you will continue to update us with your activities there and give us more information as it becomes available.
We certainly will.
Thank you, sir, for joining us.
Thank you. All right.